Hey my friends, welcome back to a new video. Today we have an interesting topic to talk about. Lies you've been told that are preventing you from walking on the timeline of the new earth. So the split is getting bigger and bigger between people who know and people who've been decepted, who've been believing into certain lies of the matrix that are preventing them from shifting. So some people will be left behind, and it's okay, it's their choice. And we are all walking here our own paths. Each of us has our own karma to resolve, our own truth to find. So everything is completely okay. The point is that you walk the path that is the most meaningful, purposeful, and enthusiastic for you. So before we go on, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. And I also want to share with you that today I'm playing a painting by the name The Source that is deeply connected to today's message. There's a lot of sacred geometry in this painting that serves as an activation of our inner senses, and especially one of the most important senses, which is the one for pattern recognition, that helps us to find our own patterns. Because patterns lead us into the known, into the predictable. But through pattern recognition, we also get deeper into the truth. So this inner sense for pattern recognition can help us to learn to read our own behaviors, our own personality, and recognize where we've fallen off the grace. So then we can step back into grace and flow with life. So I hope you're enjoying in this one. So the first lie you've been told is that life is all about happiness. And this is one of the greatest reasons why so many people fall into this deception of chasing something to be happy and wanting more of something and doing all kinds of different things to become happier, like chasing a certain special person and constantly seeking distraction and constantly wanting more of whatever. While there's nothing wrong with it if we know why we're doing something, but if we're chasing happiness, then we're constantly chasing something with what we attach happiness to, that certain specific thing, and then we think that we can only be happy, we can only be fulfilled when this thing is present. But because everything is fleeting, we want more of it. So we know this pattern, but still we find ourselves getting caught into it. While the truth is that life is all about life. It's all about feeling alive. It's all about giving life to life, which happens through a creative process, through a creative act. For example, when you're thinking about certain creative ideas that could bring some beauty onto this world, like an act of an artist, then as soon as you start working on these ideas, how to create something beautiful out of it, or how to create something, you start feeling more alive, you start feeling more enthusiastic about it, and you start creating something wonderful out of it. So the whole creative process becomes an experience of the flow of life. And that's where we recognize that happiness is actually like a chemistry of the byproduct of being in the flow, being in the flow state. And that's what we experience when we are walking on this timeline of the new earth. Timeline of the new earth is the timeline that leads us back to oneness, back to wholeness, back to where we are coming from. It's the timeline of the truth. So those who know are walking on the timeline of the truth, on the timeline of the new earth. And the split is happening and becoming bigger and bigger between those who know, those who are being truthful towards themselves, honest towards themselves, so then they can be honest with others. There's also a big lie or a belief that we have that we should expect other people to be honest with us, which is obviously a great virtue of compassion to expect people, or not to expect, but to be kind towards one another and to be honest and compassionate towards one another. The fact is that most people are not being truthful even towards themselves. And those are the kind of people who can't be then honest with you, with yourself. So we can't expect people to be honest with you if they're not even being honest with themselves. Sure, wish them well. Wish the best for them. Pray for their joy or happiness or fulfillment. But don't be disappointed if they're not being honest with you. Because if you're being honest with them and with yourself, it's all you can do. So focus on your greatest expression. The second lie you've been told is that you can't change. And this is another reason why people fall into this trap of a matrix system, where people are seeking constant distraction and validation and approval and all kinds of other reasons just to pull themselves away from themselves, because they think they're broken, they think they're miserable, they think there's something wrong with them and so on. Well, the truth is that you are a constant change. You're renewing yourself every single moment. So every single moment you're a renewed version of yourself. But the question is, are you present in this constant motion of changes? Or are you staying attached to a certain identity from the past? So as life is constantly changing, you're constantly changing. And change is all there is. So people who are walking in truth, who are walking on this new timeline, every single moment they are renewing themselves. They're constantly being surprised by what they're capable of, by how strong they can be, by how incredible and how creative they can be. So if you feel like that, it means that you're walking on this path of awe, of reverence for change, for life, for truth, because you understand that everything is fleeting. But it's this part of you that is non-changing that is the real you. So if you're staying in this part of you, the awareness of the non-changing part of you, then you can observe everything with ease, and you can just move through everything with ease, because you understand that actually you are an eternal being having a human experience, to have an adventure here, to have a love for an adventure here. And that is, to me, something really beautiful. And I believe that we all came here to be on an adventure and to really experience and experiment with it, to see what else can be created. The third lie you've been told is that the system we are living in will protect you. Well, it's designed to protect itself. The force that is protecting you is God, it's universe, it's life, it's source of life. That's what is protecting you. So it is encouraging you to leave fear behind, to leave scarcity behind, and tap into, once again, into this non-changing part of you, where you will find the source, where you will find God within, where you will find an infinite strength that will help you to endure anything that's happening in your life, and will help you to courageously walk through whatever may feel like being against you, because that's how you will walk in power. That's where you really become empowered and you become really powerful. So know that there is a force that is looking over you, protecting you, and changing with you, through you. And only stay aware of this part of you, and you will easily overcome fear. So we are actually not overcoming fear. We're just noticing what not to be afraid of. And therefore, we become more familiar with this part of us that knows, that believes, and that has kind of a faith into life, into the motion of life, and into this great knowing that things will work out and everything will happen the way it needs to happen for the greatest possible evolution of yourself. The fourth lie you've been told is that money doesn't matter. Many people have this belief that money doesn't matter. While in many cases money may not matter much, but abundance does. Abundance is a frequency, it's a state we embody when we embody power, when we embody the source energy, we embody abundance, because life is abundant, nature is abundant, universe is abundant. So abundance is this energy of power, energy of strength, and it strengthens us. It makes us more magnetic for abundance of life. So if we have this belief that money doesn't matter, we also believe that abundance is not in our access. While we actually go from believing that money doesn't matter into embodying the energy of abundance, we recognize that money is just one stream of abundance. And if we are plugged to abundance, if every single day we start our day by getting ourselves into the frequency of abundance, into, you know, reminding yourself, breathing is inhaling the abundance of life and exhaling abundance of life. Seeing colors is abundance of light. Seeing nature, how it's constantly growing without you needing to interact with it, it will be evolving. It's the abundance of expression of life. When you remind yourself of that, you recognize your body is filled with life. The force that sparks life within your cells, that's abundance. So when you remind yourself of that, you stop thinking that, you know, money doesn't matter and you should be broke or you're not capable of whatever. You recognize abundance is your birthright. So people who are walking on this new timeline of the new earth, those people are walking in abundance and they are attracting abundance in their lives. They have abundant ideas and they are taking care of them. They are taking great amount of action with them because they understand that this world will not change without you becoming the change, without you embodying these abundant ideas. So follow this part of you that has a heart of truth. Always follow this part of you. The fifth lie you've been told that is trying to separate you from the truth is that being emotional makes you weak. This is an old belief, and many people still hold on to this. Being emotional makes you weak. Sure, you can't be, I mean, being emotional may not help you in inappropriate situations, but emotions are the language of your body. That's how your body speaks to you when it's going through something, when it's feeling something you're ignoring. Your body is a very sensitive vehicle, very sensitive one. And through emotions, it will tell you what's wrong, what's right, what's happening, what serves you, what doesn't serve you. So emotions are signals from your body for you to take care of what's happening. Emotions are energy in motion that if it's fluid, if it really is in motion, you will feel high emotions of joy, of happiness, of enthusiasm, of passion, of creativity, of bliss, of curiosity, of awe and reverence for life. When this energy gets stuck because of certain reasons, usually because you're doing something that's not in alignment with you, you're in places that are sabotaging you, or you're maybe eating, consuming food that is toxic for you, consuming information that is toxic for you, this energy will start to get stuck because you're ignoring signals. And longer we are ignoring signals, more of this energy will get stuck, and that stuck energy start to feel more dense one, more negative one. That's when we describe like feeling negative emotions. Fear is not the same, because fear, again, is an important signal. It can protect us or it can destroy us. So we need to have a great awareness, and we need to learn to identify what emotion we feel. So then we can notice and learn what to do with it. But being emotional doesn't make you weak. Being emotional makes you emotional being. And then through the process of evolution, you learn to become more emotionally intelligent. And when you become more emotionally intelligent, you learn to channel your emotions. And that's when you start to use your emotions as a fuel. Your emotions are life force moving through you, and they are a fuel for your body. So you can use them then to be fueled by them. When you tap into any kind of emotion, you can use it for an expression. And if you embody the virtue of compassion, you will never use your emotions to harm someone, to do something bad or negative for someone. So be wise around that. The sixth lie you've been told is that your beauty depends on the likes and attention you receive on social media. This is something in the Matrix that is just becoming more and more toxic for many young people. While the truth is that your authenticity makes you beautiful. Finding, knowing who you are and being yourself makes you beautiful. You don't need to seek attention for that, because you just feel okay with being yourself. But interesting thing happens that when you're being yourself and when you're really being content with life, you become so magnetic that people feel attracted to you. People want to acknowledge you and want to learn from you, and people will respect you, they will honor you, they will appreciate you, because there's not many authentic people. So the truth is, people who are walking on this new timeline of the new earth, those are authentic people, those are truthful people. Those are people who know who they are, and they can easily express their authenticity. They can easily say no to things that don't resonate with them. And they are saying yes to life. They are saying yes to what really sparks this joy for life. So it's just something to reflect on, where you find yourself in. And it's not about blaming anyone or anything. Each of us is here to take our own lessons. So even social media and everything can serve its purpose for us to learn what we need to learn. But make sure that you are being authentic, that you know who you are, and that you are being the greatest possible expression of yourself, and again being then compassionate and honest with others. And the seventh lie you've been told is that success is when you reach your goals. This is a great lie in the Matrix that poisons you with this knowing that you're not enough, with a belief that you're not good enough until you have this great car and this great house and this successful business and this whatever. You will never feel successful enough to say that you are good enough, as long as you're holding on to this belief. While people who've splitted from this nonsense and started walking in truth, they know that success really is in connectedness, in being content with yourself, in knowing that each moment you're changing, each knowing you're renewing yourself, each knowing each moment you are overcoming your old self and becoming a fresh new version of yourself, when you're adopting healthier habits and letting go of the toxic ones, when you are adopting a new belief, a new mindset that is healthy and constructive for you, and letting go of the old one, that is success. When you're taking steps towards greatness and you stop sabotaging because of being afraid or not feeling good enough, that's success. Every time when you try, it's a success. Every time you see yourself as greatness, as an embodiment of life, it's success. An interesting thing happens for anyone who's doing that, just naturally attracts more success towards you. For example, if you start living your life more creatively, like rather than seeing everything that's bad, you ask yourself, how can I truly be a part of a solution here? Life will give you ideas. And those ideas came to you because you're ready to make something out of it. It's like the universe has chosen you to make something out of this idea. That's how people that are walking on this timeline of the new earth are living their lives. If you grab these ideas, organize them, and take huge amount of action with them, because we are partially physical, we are partially mystical, right, and partially divine. So we need to understand that as much as we're living in this dimension of nothingness and wholeness and infinity, we're also physical. So ideas come to us for us to channel them here. So we need to learn to organize them and to take a huge amount of action with them. When we understand this process, that is a success. When we are making sure that every single day we're living the way that this becomes our priority, to organize and to take action with these ideas that are finding us, that's a success. So we become quite abundant in mind, in thinking, and abundant in action. And that is an attitude of a successful human being. That's where success begins. And if you stay there, success will find you, because that's the law. So it's not so much about reaching your goals. When you're focusing on manifesting something, sure, have a vision. That's what I'm always reminding you. Have goals for yourself. But know that success is that every single moment you're taking care of nurturing it, like nurturing your inner mental garden, then also nurture your physical manifestation of it through taking action, organizing yourself. That's what people who are walking on the timeline of the new earth are doing. So they are well organized, and to be well organized, you also need to be in clarity. So you can't keep poisoning yourself with too much of information. You've most probably noticed, like in medieval times, people were killed for exposing the truth. Now there's so much of information that the truth can easily be hidden in the sea of information. So it's almost similar as not exposing it, because it's just, you know, hidden in too much of everything. So only clarity is the cure for everything right now. Clarity is the cure, because also because of the new energy coming in, many of us are becoming more connected. So it's much easier to channel information for yourself, what you need to know. It's much easier to go into meditation, to tap to the, however you want to call this process, and channel information for yourself. So be your own guide, my friend, because your time has come. This is it for today. I hope you've enjoyed in today's painting. To anyone who would love to support my art, go and check out our Etsy store, I Draw My Passion, where you can find all of my art. Also check out our Instagram page, Attract Passion, where I'm sharing daily reminders, messages to uplift your spirit. And my art gallery on Instagram, I Draw My Passion. Check it out, two Instagram pages, Attract Passion and I Draw My Passion. Check it out. And also, I will be posting this year frequent giveaways on I Draw My Passion. So check it out, stay tuned. And I'm wishing you all a beautiful day. Stay connected, stay creative, stay loving. May your life be an adventure, my friends. Till next time, one love. Bye.